Brianna, you ready for this?
I am ready, thank you.
All right. All right, Linda, as soon as Tanya gets on, if you could start the proceedings, that would be great.
All right, we're good to go.
Hello, everyone.
Hi, Tanya. Thank you for coming.
Hi, Tanya.
Brianna, could you start your video? What happened to her?
Yeah, I was going to say, did we lose Brianna?
Yes, we did.
All right. Sorry about the delay. Let's try to get her back on, Linda.
There she is.
Hey, Brianna. So Tanya's going to walk you through the swearing in. Mm-hmm. And she'll instruct you what you need to do. And you're going to repeat after her. And you'll know when you're done. So I'll turn it over to Tanya.
Okay.
All right. Brianna, if you could raise your right hand.
Mm-hmm.
All right. I state your name.
I, Brianna Tyson.
Do solemnly swear or affirm.
Do solemnly swear and affirm.
That I will support the Constitution of the United States.
That I will support the Constitution and the United States.
The Constitution of the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania.
Constitution of the Commonwealth and Pennsylvania.
And the City Home Rule Charter.
And the City Home Rule Charter.
I take this obligation freely.
I take this obligation freely.
Without any mental reservation.
Without any mental reservations.
That I will faithfully discharge.
That I will faithfully discharge.
The duties of City Council.
The duties of City Council.
With fidelity.
With fidelity.
So help me God.
So help me God.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
All right. Congratulations, Brianna. Tanya, thank you so much.
You're
welcome.
You
got the whole slate this year, right?
Yes. Have a good night, everyone.
Thank you.
Thank you,
Tanya. All right, Brianna, congratulations on that. Now you are officially sworn in. And
all right. Thank you.
These are uncharted waters. Do you have a quick comment? Because, you know, during our inauguration, we did give everybody a chance to come in. It would only be fair to.
I just hope that I am able to uphold, I really don't. I'm so excited. I'm just thankful that I'm in this position and that I hope that I won't let down my residents and those people who count on me.
Wow, that's excellent. You would never hear me speak that shortly. Wow.
Thank you.
Good job. Okay. All right. Well, thank you, Bree. We're going to get started. And we welcome certainly you and Wesley to the body. It's exciting to see the youth, really. I mean, I keep saying not that we're that old or anything, but it's good to see the youth. So this is an important function in the city of Reading. All right, we're going to move into the agenda. We're going to start the meeting. Linda, you ready for the meeting?
I think we already started it.
Okay, good. Sorry. All right. I'm going to welcome everyone to the regular business meeting of Reading City Council here on Monday, January 10th of 2022. We're going to open this evening's meeting with invocation. Did we lose our pastor?
Yes, he had to sign off at 7:30.
Okay. Anybody want to volunteer to do a brief invocation, brief prayer? Go ahead, Marcia.
Hey, if we could just bow our heads. We are charged as city officials, both elected officials and those who serve the city, to carry out the will of government. In God we trust. Let us hope as we're moving forward that we abide by the founders of our Constitution to give us the strength to follow our Constitution in the way that it was intended, all people created equal, and that we use all our inner strength and our decision making to be able to serve the people in the best way possible. So help us, God. Amen.
Okay, thank you, Marcia, for that. We're gonna, if we could, please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance to the flag. All right, I pledge allegiance
to the flag of the United States of America, and to the Republic which stands one nation under God, indivisible, liberty, justice for all.
Now, I want to point out, when we're live, we sound much better than that. It's technology brings in these varying delays. So, all right. So now that we have that out of the way, Linda, can we have a roll call, please?
All right, Mr. Butler?
Here.
Ms. Cepeda Freitas?
Here.
Ms. Goodman-Hinderschitz?
Here.
Ms. Reed?
Here.
Ms. Tyson?
Here.
Ms. Ventura?
Here.
Mr. Waltman, president?
Here.
Seven present, none absent.
All right, we don't have any proclamations or presentations this evening. I believe we don't have anyone signed up, Linda, still for public comment. That's correct?
Correct, yes.
So we're gonna go on to the approval of our agenda and minutes. It includes the minutes from our December 27th, 2021 regular meeting and approving the summation of discussions from the December 27th Committee of the Whole meeting. As part of the approval of the agenda and minutes, we also approve any consent agenda legislation, and we have three items that are part of that legislation this evening. The first item is a resolution authorizing the city's bank accounts for 2022. The second item is a resolution ratifying the COVID-19 Declaration of Disaster Emergency that was executed by the mayor and council president on January 4th, 2022, and authorizing the continuance and renewal of the Declaration of Disaster Emergency not to exceed 90 days, or the expiration of any declaration of disaster emergency enacted by the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania, whichever expires later, unless further action is taken by council. And the final item under the consent agenda legislation is a resolution that authorizes the disposition of the 2015 financial interest statements, gift reports, and campaign finance reports in the city clerk's office. So all we do here is see if anybody is opposed to approving those items, the agenda, the approval of the minutes, and the consent agenda items. Is anybody opposed to that? Those items being approved. All right, if there's no opposition, they stand as approved. We're gonna move on to the next item on our agenda, and that's the administrative report. We're gonna welcome the Honorable Mayor Moran and Abe Amoros, the City Managing Director. Good evening, gentlemen.
Good evening. Council President, Council Members, and once again, I will start off report by acknowledging my activities for the last several weeks, and then the managing director would speak in behalf of reports from directors. So on December 15th, I had the honor of participating at the City Hall's Children Christmas Party, which again, I have to say that this is awe and has been done for many years, and it's always awe. Thanks to the Citizen Service Center and the generous donation of city employees. So again, praises to the Citizen Service Center for an amazing job they did once again. I had the honor of talking to several of the Millmont Elementary School children who were the school that was chosen to receive some gifts this year on City Hall. So I got an opportunity to chat with them, talk to them, receive questions, and then the fire chief and police chief brass also had an opportunity to speak to them. Also that night, I had the pleasure of singing some Christmas carols with the Reading Recreation Commission in front of the Christmas tree on 5th and Penn. On December 16th, I attended and gave remarks for the historical marker honoring the Reading birthplace of Spencer Fullerton Beard at the southwest corner of 5th and Washington. I also had the extreme honor and pleasure to meet Dr. Richard Corinne, Smithsonian Distinguished Scholar and Ambassador at Large. I also had the opportunity to give him a tour of the pagoda before he went back to Washington. On December 16, I also had a second ARPA public interview while attended. On December 21st, I attended a police donation for the No Shave November during the month of November with some police members participated, and the donation or the funding was donated to a not-for-profit organization that brings cancer awareness. On December 22nd, I attended and participated in a toy giveaway in collaboration with Daily Dove Home Care, which again, was incredibly well attended, to say the least. I also attended a few activities throughout the Christmas break or Christmas time. But on January 23rd, I attended and added closing remarks at the very inspiring inauguration ceremony for council president, city council members for several of the districts. And of course, on January 6th, I had the third mayor, Eddie Moran's Three Kings Day celebration, which was attended by over 500 families at the Doubletree. And we were able to distribute it again, some additional toys and bikes and scooters and gifts that could be utilized for children to get some exercise. And again, I want to thank publicly all the partners that made that day very special. So I'll pass it on to City Council, to the Managing Director, Ms. Amaraz.
Thank you, Mayor. And it's good to be back with everybody. I'm on the other side of COVID. I want to thank everyone who wished me well during that time. I tested positive on December the 22nd, so the holidays were a little rough, but I'm at 95% capacity now. And just as a public service announcement to the public, if you have not been doubly vaccinated, please do so. I had the fortune of being doubly vaccinated, and it still felt as if it was the flu on steroids. It was 100 times worse than the flu, and it was quite miserable. So do it for yourself, do it for your family, do it for your community, but be sure that you protect yourself and your loved ones by getting vaccinated. Under fire, the department's 9th and Marion Fire Station project is progressing. It's quite good news, and site work is currently underway. Under the Human Relations Commission, as of the end of the year, 1,171 total rent and utility assistance applications were received, and the rental assistance and utility assistance programs have helped 283 city families for a total of $1,090,585. Hardship funds have assisted 221 city members
in the amount of $48,397. Under library, it's my privilege to introduce Melissa Adams, who is now the new executive director for the Reading Public Library System. And she and Bronwyn Gamble, the retiring executive director, met with the mayor and myself last month to introduce Melissa. So we wish her the very best moving forward. Under finance, under IT, a total of 521 help desk tickets were completed in December, which was a very busy month. Computers have been reserved for Motorola training, and it's established that adequate space is available at the wastewater treatment plant to begin working on them as well. Department personnel attended last month's Tyler sessions and have been assigned to attend the January 11th through the January 13th sessions as well, including myself, so I look forward to that training. And of course, the department personnel provided assistance to human resources to resolve a VPN and other issue related matters working remotely 3 days this week. So Comcast related issues, which resulted in disruptions in remote site operations, are also resolved, which is a good news as well. And the weekend changeover of the second floor network rack has been finally complete. Under accounting, Caroline Rodriguez attended a meeting among the following personnel to discuss the Munis daily cash process procedures, Penny Lau, Rick Kantner, and Trenton Holtz. We want to thank them for participating in that training as well. The 2020 Munis budget revenue figures were verified and confirmed with the USL 2020 budget amounts and forwarded to the accountant for review and approval. Finance assistant aided department staff with the expenditures figures portion, and the accounting manager also attended several Munis training opportunities. Under grants, we've been awarded $237,000 for the Reading Iron Playground, $600,000 from DCD for CFA Multimodal Transportation Funds, $129,230 for PennDOT. This match for this grant must be confirmed, take place very shortly. And of course, others, including the Six and Amity Playground designs, were sent to project manager today, as a matter of fact, for review. And a kickoff meeting was going to be held with DCNR as well. The law office is currently also working on the skate park documents to get that on the police. Hired 18 officers, 9 have Act 120 certification and will begin field training. 9 will complete Act 120 training at the police academy before starting field training. And 2 officers were selected at school neighborhood police officers. The Reading School District has thanked us for that as well. Key personnel completed Munis training for the rollout of the new finance software. And Lieutenant Lillis attended several holiday toy giveaways in December and events for children representing the Reading Police Department. Under Public Works, the position of sustainability manager has been filled, with Bethany Ayers Fisher assuming that role, as many of you know. And of course, Kyle Zieber has been named by Mayor Moran as the acting Public Works director for the time being. The Buttonwood Gateway Project kickoff meeting took place last week at 10 a.m. A Heritage Park outfall DEP permit was received. Construction should begin during spring of 2022. Rawa also contacted sewers for assistance regarding another sinkhole in the 1500 block of Chester. The street curb and yard started dropping into what looks like another sinkhole on the west side of the street. The earlier incident was on the east side, and this time about 15 feet of sewer pipe compromise and collapse into the hole, but Rawa provided the excavator to help repair the sewer pipe before completing the sinkhole repair. UGI was also scheduled to relocate the gas main in this block and modify their original plans as well. Electrical repairs to the wastewater treatment effluent emergency generator and 19th Ward PS pump were also completed following the discovery of problems with scheduled preventative maintenance. And stop signs were erected at Second and Buttonwood as a safety measure for pedestrians and school children who need to use that intersection as well. And under human resources, the W-2s have been prepared and disseminated to most employees. The wellness committee is going to be entering and processing enrollment packets for all personnel. already looking at ordering gym equipment for City Hall, waiting for the check from a broker as well, and working on 2021 final invoices for benefit vendors. So that concludes my report. I'm happy to answer any and all questions from council members if you have any.
Okay, council, anybody have any questions or comments for the mayor or the managing director? All right, if not, thank you, Eddie and Abe for the report. We appreciate that. We are gonna move on to the report from our city auditor. While we're doing that, I'm actually gonna be switching devices. I'm having problems here with my computer. I'll be back in 2 minutes, but go ahead, Maria. Thank you.
Thank you, Council President. Good evening, everyone. The first item on my report is the property tax revenue update as of November 30th, 2021. For the current year, the city budgeted $24,649,055 for property taxes, which include property tax current, property tax prior, penalty and interest, and discounts and allowance. And as of November 30, 2021, the city had recorded about $25 million, and this amount has already exceeded its budget target by $365,086.50. For the same period, 2020, the city recorded about $23 million, or 93% of total amount budgeted, which is about $1.7 million less than the revenue recorded this year. However, $178,945 less was budgeted for this revenue line item in 2021 than compared to 2020. The liquid fuels tax form for the period of January 1st, 2019 to December 31st, 2020. On December 2nd, 2021, the city auditor's office received the final audit report of the liquid fuel tax form for the Office of the Auditor General for the years of 2019 and 2020. For these 2 years, there were no audit findings. The city auditor office worked very closely with the city controller, Michael Oppenheimer, and the public works engineering, Timothy Crow, in providing all the information that was needed by the state auditor, Mr. Stappi, in order for him to be able to complete this audit. The third, I just gonna update on some miscellaneous update. On December 31, 2021, the city fire department received a grant from FEMA in the amount of $983,671.82 for the assistance of the firefighters. This fund will be used for the purchase of the EMS equipment. On January 11, 2022, tomorrow, the city auditor office will be meeting with the staff of the finance department to review the process flow for the daily revenue cash received in the treasury department with the purpose of conducting an audit in that department in the near future. As we all know, the treasury department records most of the revenue and makes all the transfers that are needed in order for the city to pay bills, payroll transfer, and stuff like that. So this is my report for tonight. I'm open for any questions that you might have. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Maria. Council members, I'm using a different device, so I can't see anybody raising their hand, but if anybody has a comment or question, please interject at this time. All right. If not, Maria, thank you for the report. We are going to move on to the next item on our agenda, and that is going to be ordinances for final passage.
The first ordinance is Bill number 96-2021, amending Chapter 23, Section 101 of the City Code by changing the number of members of the Planning Commission from 5 to 7 members. This was introduced at the 13th regular meeting and tabled at the December 27th regular meeting. Is there a motion, please?
So moved.
You cut out there.
I apologize. Is there a motion? Okay. Was there another motion? Was there a motion to amend this? Anybody?
Yes. I motion to amend Section 2 of the ordinance. The ordinance shall become effective on March 1st, 2022, pursuant to section 219 and 221 of the City of Reading Home Rule Charter.
I'll second that.
All right, is there any comment? There's been a motion seconded to amend it. Does anybody have any comments on the amendment?
Steph, you were going in and out. Can you repeat what you said, please?
I was asking, does anybody have any comments on the amendment?
No, the ordinance, the actual, what we're amending.
Yeah, there's an amendment on the table now, Melissa. Do you have any comments on the amendment?
Yeah, what is the amendment?
Okay, do you want me to read it again?
Thank you.
Okay. I have made a motion to amend section 2 of the ordinance that this ordinance shall become effective on March 1st, 2022, pursuant to section 219 and 222 of the City of Reading Home Rule Charter. Donna seconded that.
What's the amendment for what? I couldn't hear.
That was the amendment.
That was the amendment.
Was to make it effective March 1 of 2022.
I think you just need to clarify it for them. It's the ordinance that's proposed to increase the number of planning commission members from 5 to 7. So it's just
right.
The first part is you have to amend it because the effective date needs to be updated to be March 1st. So that's step one.
Thanks, Mike.
Yep.
All right, any other comments on the amendment? If not, Linda, can we take a roll call, please?
Motion was made by Councilor Goodman-Henderson, seconded by Councilor Reed, to adopt the amendment to Bill number 96, which increases the number of Planning Commission members from 5 to 7. And the amendment is by adjusting the effective date to March 1st, 2022. Mr. Butler.
Yes.
Mr. Peter Freitas.
Yes.
Ms. Goodman-Henderson.
Yes.
Ms. Reed.
Yes.
Ms. Tyson.
Yes. Thank you.
Ms. Ventura.
Yes.
Mr. Walton, President.
Yes.
7 yeas, no nays.
Okay, now that the ordinance is properly amended, we will vote on the ordinance as amended. Does anybody have any comments or questions on the ordinance as amended?
Jeff, if I can. Having served on a planning commission prior to being on council, it's hard to really explain how important that entity is. And there have been problems getting a quorum with the lesser number of members we've had. So to increase the number of members, bring on more points of view, and also helping to make sure that we have quorums as the city continues on a positive note of development. That's very, very important. Again, it's land use, it's all the important things that go into a growing and an economically healthy city. So this is a very important entity, and having quorum and more folks on it is only a good thing for all of us.
All right, thank you, Donna. Does anybody else have any comments on this ordinance? Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay, great. All right, if there are no other comments, Linda, can we have a roll call on the ordinance itself?
Motion was made by Councilor Goodman-Henderson, seconded by Councilor Reed, to enact Bill number 96, 2021 as amended. Mr. Peter Freitas?
I don't think she's on anymore.
Yeah, I think we're okay.
Let's give her a minute to rejoin. Come back to her vote.
Okay. Ms. Goodman-Henderson?
Yes.
Ms. Reed?
Yes.
Ms. Tyson?
Yes.
Ms. Ventura?
Yes.
Mr. Butler?
Yes.
Linda?
Yeah, she's still not connected.
Okay, I'll just take my vote and we can revisit her when she gets back on.
Mr. Waltman, President.
Yes.
So we have six yeas and no nays.
Yep.
Right now.
You should just got back on.
I can take a vote now. There you go.
Ms. Cepeda Freitas, are you okay to vote on the amendment to Bill Number 96, 2021, with the adjusted effective date?
Yes.
Okay. Great. So then we have seven yeas, no nays.
All right, we'll move on to the next ordinance, Bill Number 106-2021, amending the City Code Chapter 23, Part 1201, Downtown Revitalization Public-Private Partnership. This was introduced at the December 13th regular meeting and tabled at the December 27th regular meeting. Is there a motion, please?
Move to table.
Second.
All right, it's been properly moved and seconded. On a table motion, we don't have comments. So we'll just ask Linda to take a roll call on the table motion.
Motion was made by Councilor Reed, seconded by Councilor Goodman-Hinderschitz to table Bill Number 106-2021. Ms. Goodman-Hinderschitz?
Yes.
Ms. Reed?
Yes.
Ms. Tyson?
Yes.
Ms. Ventura?
Yes.
Mr. Butler?
Yes.
Ms. Goodman-Hinderschitz? Oops, I'm sorry, Ms. Cepeda Freitas?
Yes.
Mr. Waltman, President?
Yes.
Seven yeas, no nays.
All right, the next ordinance is Bill Number 1-2022, allocating $3 million of the ARPA funding to First Energy Stadium for the required stadium improvements. And this was introduced at the December 27th regular meeting. Is there a motion, please?
So moved.
Second.
It's been properly moved and seconded. Are there any comments? And again, I apologize, I can't see anybody. If somebody wants to speak up first, that'd be great.
Jeff, just to note that, you know, this is money put to a good use. The stadium serves an important role, not just primarily, of course, for the RPHILs, but also it is a community meeting place. It hosts many events. The improvements and what is going to be happening here through the partnership of the county, the state, and the RPHILs club itself will provide additional venues for community events, nonprofits, as well as profit events. And it's just enhancing what is really a jewel of a facility that we've had here in the city of Reading since 1950. It has grown since then. And I'm very happy to see this occur. And of course, and for full disclosure, it's in District 5, so see me even happier. So I hope everyone can support this.
All right. Are there any additional comments?
Yes, Jeff. First of all, I fully support this, but I also see as we're moving ahead, the First Energy Stadium and the Reading Phillies are an example of a strong partnership. I think that we should be continuing to direct our ARP money to those strong assets we have in our city. And as we move ahead, I think there'll be recommendations coming forward. We need to take care of those things that are important to our city's economy and also for tourism within the city.
Okay, are there any additional comments? All right, I just wanna thank the Reading Phillies and all the state legislators who helped facilitate this effort. And we look forward to the continued success of the Reading Phillies. With that in mind, Linda, can we have a roll call, please?
Motion was made by Councilor Reed, seconded by Councilor Goodman-Hinderschitz to enact Bill Number 1-2022, which allocates $3 million in ARPA funding to First Energy Stadium for the MLB required stadium improvements. Ms. Reed?
Yes.
Ms. Tyson?
Yes, Ms. Donna.
Ms. Ventura?
Yes.
Mr. Butler?
Yes.
Ms. Cepeda Freitas?
Yes.
Ms. Goodman-Hinderschitz?
Yes.
Mr. Waltman, President?
Yes.
Seven yeas, no nays.
The next ordinance is Bill Number 2-2022, authorizing a budget amendment for unscheduled demolitions by transferring $152,000 from the finance IT area to the CD trades area. And this was introduced at the December 27th regular meeting. Is there a motion, please?
So moved.
Second.
It's been properly moved and seconded. Are there any comments? If there are no comments, Linda, can we have a roll call, please?
Motion was made by Councilor Reed, seconded by Councilor Ventura to enact Bill Number 2, 2022, which authorizes a budget amendment to cover the costs of unscheduled demolitions during 2021. Ms. Tyson?
I'm okay with that.
Okay. Ms. Ventura?
Yes.
Mr. Butler?
Yes.
Ms. Cepeda Freitas?
Yes.
Ms. Goodman-Hinderschitz?
Yes.
Ms. Reed?
Yes.
Mr. Waltman, President?
Yes.
Seven yeas, zero nays.
All right, the next ordinance is Bill Number 3-2022, authorizing a budget amendment to cover self-insurance expenses through the end of 2021, liability claims in the amount of $155,200, premium payments in the amount of $101,100, and other insurance premium in the amount of $63,700. This is all going to be funded by an increase in the transfer from the fund balance line item in the amount of total amount of $320,000. This was introduced at the December 27th regular meeting. Is there a motion, please?
Second.
All right, it's been properly moved and seconded. Does anybody have any comments on this specific ordinance? If not, Linda, can we have a roll call, please?
Motion was made by Councilor Cepeda Freitas, seconded by Councilor Goodman-Hinderschitz, to enact Bill Number 3, 2022, which authorizes a budget amendment to cover self-insurance expenses through the end of 2021. Ms. Ventura?
Yes.
Mr. Butler?
Yes.
Ms. Cepeda Freitas?
Yes.
Ms. Goodman-Hinderschitz?
Yes.
Ms. Reed?
Yes.
Ms. Tyson?
Yes.
Mr. Waltman, President?
Yes.
Seven yeas, no nays.
Okay, we have some new wording on this ordinance. Let me just pull that up real quick. All right, Bill Number 4-2022, authorizing budget transfer of $100,000 with Solid Waste Division to provide funding to assist with costs incurred for the construction and or purchase of screening for dumpsters and receptacles located in the right-of-way as per the newly enacted dumpster ordinance. Is there a motion, please?
So moved.
Second.
Okay, it's been properly moved and seconded. Are there any comments? If there are no comments, Linda, can we have a roll call, please?
Motion was made by Councilor Goodman-Hinderschitz, seconded by Councilor Cepeda Freitas, to enact Bill Number 4, 2022, which authorizes a budget transfer of $100,000 within the Solid Waste Division to provide funding for costs incurred for the dumpster screening. Mr. Butler?
Yes.
Ms. Cepeda Freitas?
Yes.
Ms. Goodman-Hinderschitz?
Yes.
Ms. Reed?
Yes.
Ms. Tyson?
Yes.
Ms. Ventura?
Yes.
Mr. Waltman, President?
Yes.
Seven yeas, no nays.
All right, our next ordinance is Bill Number 5-2022, amending the 2022 position ordinance as per the mayor to reflect the change in the title of the position of executive assistant to the mayor's office to special assistant and to reflect an increase in the base salary of the special assistant position from $53,000 to $63,652. This was introduced at the December 27th regular meeting. Is there a motion, please?
Move to table.
Second.
All right, there's a motion on the table to table. We don't normally have discussion during a table motion. You can vote yes to support the table or no in opposition of tabling the ordinance. Linda, can we have a roll call, please?
Motion was made by Councilor Reed, seconded by Councilor Cepeda Freitas to table Bill number 5, 2022. Ms. Cepeda Freitas?
Yes.
Ms. Goodman-Hinderschitz?
Yes.
Ms. Reed?
Yes.
Ms. Tyson?
No.
Ms. Ventura?
Yes.
Mr. Butler?
Yes.
Mr. Waltman, President?
No.
5 yeas, 2 nays.
Okay, our final ordinance for passage this evening, and I'm gonna try to get through this one, is Bill 6-2022, amending the city code by creating chapter 317, invasive plants and noxious weeds to regulate and provide guidance to landowners to responsibly control invasive plants and noxious weeds to allow the reestablishment of native plants and to implement the city's obligations under the Controlled Plant and Noxious Weed Act, Pennsylvania CS Section 1501. This was introduced at the December 27th regular meeting. Is there a motion, please?
So moved.
I second that.
All right, it's been properly moved and seconded. Are there any comments regarding this ordinance? Go ahead, Marcia. Yeah.
Okay. This is the final one in the series of recommendations through the Environmental Advisory Board and or Council, and is very important to be able to help homeowners understand that they shouldn't be dumping what they consider yard waste, which may indeed include invasive plants and weeds, into city property. And I've seen this happen in my area because I live on the boundary of a lot of, well, the Neversink Mountain Preserve, that what happens is these things take hold, and then what they do is they destroy the normal plants in that area and can really, in fact, destroy some of our much valued forest areas. So I would strongly ask council to support the passage of this ordinance.
All right, are there any additional comments? If not, Linda, can we have a roll call, please?
Motion was made by Councilor Goodman-Hinderschitz, seconded by Councilor Ventura, to enact Bill number 6, 2022, which amends the city code by creating chapter 317, invasive plants and noxious weeds, to regulate and provide guidance about the need to control invasive plants. Ms. Goodman-Hinderschitz?
Yes.
Ms. Reed?
Yes.
Ms. Tyson?
Yes.
Ms. Ventura?
Yes.
Mr. Butler?
Yes.
Ms. Peter Freitas?
Yes.
Mr. Waltman, President?
Yes.
7 yeas, no nays.
Okay, we have.
Linda, that was technically seconded by Ms. Tyson.
Ah, thank you.
Oh, that's right. Thank you.
Thank you, Bree.
All right, so that is it for ordinances for voting this evening. We do have 4 ordinances for introduction. I'm going to ask the Councilwoman Marcia Goodman-Hinderschitz to please read them onto the record.
Okay. A, bill amending the city code chapter 576, snow and ice emergency. B, bill authorizing the administration to write off the net unreimbursed cost allocations recorded between the general fund and the city's water fund, where the city's water fund was to reimburse the general fund in a net amount of $157,636.48, with both be adjusted to zero. C, bill amending the City Code Chapter 5, Part 202, General Provisions, by adding the third class city code requirement for council members to be sworn into office within 14 days of the organization meeting. And D, bill directing the Berks County Board of Elections to place a referendum question before city voters on the 222 primary election ballot, which would amend the City of Reading Home Rule Charter by eliminating the requirement for the City Public Works Director to be a civil engineer.
All right, thank you, Marcia, for reading them onto the table for us, and we'll vote on them in 2 weeks, hopefully. We're gonna move on to the next section of our agenda. There are no resolutions, so it's open for any council comments. If anybody has anything they need to share this evening, or anyone from the administration as well, the floor is open. I cannot see anyone, so if you have a comment, please lead the way.
Hi, Jeff, it's Johanny. It's more of a comment, and I know we'll discuss this at the later meeting, but I know we were reclassified as a second class city. So I'm just wondering how that impacts how we operate as, you know, how we carry out government duties and responsibilities. I know there were talks of getting a presentation before us to understand what that means for us.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Good point, Johanna. In the
future, huh?
Yes, and that's an excellent question, Councillor, and thank you for raising it. Last week during a meeting with PFM, Gordon Mann did confirm that he was going to be presenting to council members probably in February. And here's the thing. I know it sounds as if the city is getting some sort of promotion in the eyes of the Commonwealth, but second class two-way status is really doesn't have a whole lot of benefits if you have a home rule charter like the City of Reading. So I won't burst Gordon's bubble because he is presenting to us, but we did discuss that last week in our touch point with PFM. So that will be coming in February, but that is a good question. I'm glad you raised it.
All right, any additional comments or questions from council
members? I guess I have a question, and this is for our solicitor. I just read into record amending general provisions by adding the third class city code requirement. So I guess we need to look into, as we do different types of actions, whether that wording indeed needs to be changed.
Yeah, I was not aware of that change in the distinction, to be honest with you. I don't think it really has any impact on the proposed ordinance that you know, was just introduced, but you know, moving forward, we will keep that in mind when we're looking to, you know, update things. I mean, this was really just a matter, and I brought that matter to Linda's attention because I had an issue in another municipality that I represent where they had some elected officials that did not end up taking the oath and qualifying. And as we have been updating the council handbook, I noticed that there was nothing in our council rules and regulations in the administrative code to address it. So I suggested, you know, that was one of the things to update. So that's really where that came from. Didn't have anything specific to do with the third class city code.
I saw Linda noted that it doesn't. So we'll get updated when Gordon presents to us then.
Yeah, and I would just add that even if we did go the route of seeking to be upgraded, that's still a long ways off. And okay, the way this is phrased as a home rule charter, we could still follow the process in the third class city code, even if we were upgraded, or we could amend this again, because the process is going to be an involved one, and we would be looking at a lot of amendments to our ordinances.
Okay, additional comments?
Yeah, Jeff, and I had just wanted to be able to do a shout out to all that were involved with highlighting the Public Works Department for the two snows that we had, and especially with the icy conditions. As you all know, I live in a pretty treacherous area of the city when you're trying to get down off the mountain, and they were just really timely and did a wonderful job. And as I came down on the Perkiomen, same thing. Penn Street really cleared nicely. And that was all within a couple hours of the storm. So I always expect that, but I always believe it's important to give a shout out and a thanks to the hard work. And also the fact that the fire department and our police department always have to navigate through the city streets when there's challenges. So good work all around. Thank you.
Okay, additional comments, anyone?
Yeah, it's Donna, if I can. Yep. I think as city councilors, we should all send our thoughts and prayers to the folks in Philadelphia who lost so many people in that particular horrific five-alarm fire, as well as to the nearly 20 people who, including children, who were lost yesterday in the Bronx. I think the Philly situation in particular should give us pause to really take our codes situation very seriously in terms of inspections, rentals, the importance of smoke detectors. We've had fatal fires. Marsha, you had one in your district at Muhlenberg Street just last year where we've lost kids, where we've lost adults. Mm-hmm. We've been fairly fortunate. We certainly haven't had anything like what we saw in Philly or the Bronx, but all of us know that there are many, many properties in this town that were converted either illegally or improperly. We all know that codes, for years has worked and tried to keep up with everything with inspections. There have been lags, there have been issues. But I hope that, we look at this new year and we see the tragedies that occurred in these two cities. And we have a refreshed and a renewed and a vigorous movement forward with our codes department, that we look at every single rental property in the city and see what is going on, see if there's overcrowding situations, see if there's improper conversions, and really take this to heart, because I'm sure you all feel the same as I do. We don't want to lose one person to fire, much less the multiple fatality tragedies that we've seen in these two cities. And again, the Philadelphia situation really concerns me in terms of how analogous it is to our particular row house situation here in the city of Reading, and so many conversions. And again, as we go through the economic difficulties that we're going through, 28 people in one row house in Philadelphia and two units or something. I mean, we know, and I've talked with different landlords who know that, many multiple families are going into one unit because of the increasing cost of rent. So we have a lot of situations here to deal with. And I ask the administration very respectfully, but also very forcefully, that our codes be reinvigorated to look at all our properties for the safety of the people who live in them and our first responders. I think there's nothing we can do more important in protecting and serving our people than to do that in this year, as we see what has happened, unfortunately, in the two cities that I'm sure many of us have roots in and care about.
All right, any additional comments? Nobody has any additional comments? Okay, let's see here. We're gonna just wrap it up with going over the meeting schedule. That is as follows. Next Tuesday, January 18th, we have the Nominations and Appointments Committee at 4:00. That'll be followed immediately by our next Committee of the Whole meeting at 5:00. And then on January 24th, we have the Committee of the Whole meeting at 5:00. And that is immediately followed by our next regular City Council business meeting. With that in mind, if there's no other order of business, we simply need someone just to make an motion to adjourn.
I just wanted to clarify, that's not what we're going to be doing next week.
Well, I didn't reference Monday night's meeting, but yes, we were going to do the orientation on Monday night. Yep.
Yeah, and then on January 18th. Okay. That's fine.
All right. Is there a motion to adjourn, please?
Can I motion to adjourn since today is my first day?
You absolutely
for sure.
I motion to adjourn, please.
All right. Well, thank you, Brianna, and everybody have a great night.
Thank you.
See you guys later.
Good night, everyone.
Good night, everyone.
Good night, everybody.